In this video, I want to show you different ways of how to draw a window. I just do it in my front view. I just go into rectangle and I choose my first pointer point in the center. And then I just say I want to have 5 meters in X direction and 3 meters in Y direction. This is my outside window frame. And then I go and select this curve. I just say offset. And you can choose, for example, a distance of 15 centimeters, somewhat like this, inside or outside. I'll just do it to the inside. And then you have two curves. You select both of them. And I'll just double click on this to see this in perspective. The next thing you do is you just click enter extrude curve. And here you can see how much you want to extrude the curve. I also would say, I don't know, probably 0.8 centimeters, somewhere like this. And this could be your window frame. And then you want potentially draw a window, a glass window inside. And you can just do it with your object snap. If you have object snap and gumbo selected, and especially also midpoint, then you just choose your surface from 3 or 4 corners. You can also just say a rectangle and say a rectangle, then you have one step more. And I just do this right now. I just go and choose here the midpoint, and I will just go to this side, choose the midpoint, okay, and I just move this around and choose midpoint here. Excellent. Now I have a curve inside. If I would have taken the surface from 3 or 4 corners, I would immediately have a surface. But I can just choose this curve, and under under surface, I just choose patch. And I think you don't need anything of these surface bands. I think that's fine. And you just say okay. And then you have your surface inside. And for the visualization, I definitely recommend that you give this this material, and I go into material and I just say material by object, and I just for example say that this is clear glass. And if I go into my render mode, then you can see that it's working pretty well. Another way of doing it is you probably draw a window somewhere like this, and proportions don't matter now, but that's not so important to me. And you have a window which consists of different frames. I press enter again and have another one, and have another one. And here you can see I really don't do it nicely and precisely. But anyhow, it doesn't matter. If you have selected these and you just go into extrude, also the same distance, and you just toggle to your perspective, then you can see that this is also an option of how to draw windows. I did it really quickly, so it's definitely much too thick, but you can get an idea that with extrude and just selecting different kind of curves inside, outside, it also works really well. Okay, another option, a third option could be that you just have a wall and just draw a box, and just enter 0.3. And this is my box. Just have a look at this in perspective. This is my box. And you just want to draw an opening of a window inside. Then this sits, for example, like here. And you just use the Boolean operation. Just move it down a little bit like this. And now you see there's an intersection between the box, between these two boxes. And if you select the basic box and you just say boolean and then difference, then it says select surface of polar surfaces to subtract with. That's the second one, and press enter, and here we go. And you just cut your opening into this kind of wall. I just want to remind you that there is this really handy feature of smart track, and I just want to position this Boolean operation window really clearly in my wall. And what I do is just select my object and I go into box corner. I want to draw this box, and I just go and have the smart track selected. You can just see that the smart track is working, and I enter the relative value of 2 meters in x direction, 2, 2 in y direction, and I finish it now. And now again I go in relative mode again at 5 centimeters in y direction, and for example like 3 centimeters in 5 centimeters in x direction and 3 centimeters in y direction. I just give it a height of 16 centimeters, and if I just go into my top view again, then this is my my object, and that's definitely much too big, but it doesn't matter. I go again into my Boolean and just say again I want to subtract this one, and here we go, and now I position it precisely. You can also immediately position your window and your already existing 3D model. Then I would choose my rectangle function slightly different. Smart track I just deselect again. I go into my rectangle and I choose rectangle 3 points. I have midpoints selected, and I select my first midpoint of this is this one. And then I just navigate to this point, also midpoint. I can see this properly, excellent. And I just choose now the other midpoint, for example, like this midpoint. And so my curve sits properly in the middle of this window. And here again, I just go into my my front view, and I just enter offsets. Probably also not a bad idea to isolate this. I just open my window and I just say isolate window, so I can see this better. I just enter offset, and I want to have an offset of 8 centimeters, 0.8, somewhere like this, and want to have it to the middle, and I choose both and just say extrude curve, and probably a decent dimension of 8 centimeters, and we have our window again. And we can also like this draw our glass, that's obvious. And now again I just say show object, also objects, right mouse click, and here we go.